Quantitative data is quickly becoming the language of K-12 education as well as academic institutions. On the K-12 level, this was a movement that was started gaining traction in the 90s and then was really sort of spearheaded by No Child Left Behind. A lot of the legislation that we see, according to some of the documents as well as some of the writings that have been written about No Child Left Behind at that time, have questioned the original intent of collecting data or of, some of the practices, I guess the more business-leaning or business-inspired practices that were written in No Child Left Behind. However, since No Child Left Behind, the look to data or the focus on data has started showing the potential of focusing on data and focusing on effective practices. In fact, how we can be effective teachers by analyzing effective practices and what works in the classroom and focus on what works according to the quantitative data that has been recorded by teachers, districts, and even data that you yourself have taken in your own classroom. Now, moving the focus to special education, data is critically important when we look at individualized education plans, IEPs, because it's, because IEPs are things that we have to look over at the federal level, or we receive scrutiny from the federal level, we need to make sure that our plans, that the learning tracks within our plans, are one, being met by us as teachers, and also that we're seeing progress from students inside the classroom. And the only way to effectively measure progress is to be able to point at data or at quantitative data to show that growth is being met. However, you can't just it's what is important though is that when you do collect data, you have to have a purpose behind collecting the data. And you also need to make sure that you're interpreting the data, correctly. While there has been a huge advent of data collecting in education, whether or not the data has been interpreted correctly or whether or not the data has been interpreted at all, it really depends on the district and on whether or not they put in a lot of focus on doing something with that data. This is related to this idea of fidelity, which is staying true to the research, to the data that you have collected, and also implementing it in accordance to the research, how the research met for it to be implemented. Another key aspect of this, when you collect data, is focusing on this idea. Focusing on the idea of modification versus accommodations. So, modification could be modifying your instructor in certain instruction in certain ways that could be effective for students. But in order to make sure that these modifications are appropriate, you have to look at you have to focus on the data that's collected about the specific student. So if in an individualized education plan, you see that a child may have a very difficult time reading the material, or maybe the child has a disability that makes it very difficult to read the material, you can focus on getting an audiobook so that the child could listen to the content instead of reading the content. Now, This is, you know, distinctly different than an accommodation. An accommodation would be something as if maybe the child has a very difficult time seeing, or maybe the child has, you know, issues with vision. You can move the child up to the front of the classroom to accommodate to the child's strengths and make sure that the child has the best opportunity to learn inside your classroom. All of this, though, it's what's critically important, though, is that when you make these decisions, whether you're making accommodations or modifications in the classroom, you have to record when you're making these changes and also the effectiveness of these changes. Because if you don't do that, then the massive problem is you're going to have a very difficult time measuring the effectiveness of these changes and whether or not these changes are effective at all. At the end of the day, it's critically important that we as teachers take this responsibility to, one, focus on collecting data on all of our students or collecting data on our classrooms, but also modifying our instruction so that each student has the best opportunity to learn. You know, our responsibility as teachers is to make sure that we can provide the opportunity for students so that they can become the people that they want to be or the people that they're born to be. But the only way we can make that happen is if we do the work on the back end to make sure that we can give students the appropriate opportunities to succeed. Thank you for your time today.